this time is because during the day I always have to make a lot of edits when I film in the day, and the reason for that is because there's always noise of some sort, and I try my best to negate as much noise as possible, especially because when I'm listening to ASMR I like to fall asleep to it, like actually fall asleep. Sometimes I don't just watch it for fun, so that's why in this video I decided to film it really early in the morning or late at night. I stayed up to film this. I decided to do that because I wanted to be considerate of noises, as my water bottle just cracked in the last 2 seconds while I was holding it. I don't know why plastic is so loud. Anyways, I edited it out so you didn't hear it at all, but don't judge me. I got some water from Walmart. This is my water. No, but I really don't drink Walmart water. The water's so ass. I literally, I'll pour it into my plants and then I'll refill it with this water that I get from my water filtration system. But yeah, anyways. Okay, so I literally don't have an agenda. I'm just doing whatever I want to do. And, yeah, just having a little chit-chat with you all. Anyways, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. And if you're new here, subscribe. And click the notification bell so you know whenever I'm around. Anyways, enjoy the video. I don't know what you had for dinner tonight, but I wanted to ask that. Because tonight I had vegetable curry. It was Thai curry, and I had it over a bed of white rice, and oh my god, something about Thai food, I don't know what it is, it's the spices, they always taste so good, and no matter how hard I try to replicate Thai spice, or as far as the curries are concerned, the spice for the curries, it comes out exactly the same, and I don't know what it is. I feel like I put enough turmeric. I don't know if it's a different curry powder, or if they don't use a curry powder, they do it from scratch, which a lot of people usually do, so they get the curry leaves or whatever, but I don't got time for that. I just want to eat. So but I've never really been able to successfully replicate it, but I think it's also my thing station into it. I'm sure I could accomplish it. Oh my gosh. If you yawned with me, give me a like. Just kidding. I guess I was a little bit more tired than I thought. But, okay. So, other ASMRists might also experience this. When I'm listening to my own ASMR, or when I'm doing ASMR, when I hear myself, I literally get tingles while doing it. Oh, I know. Ooh, this sounds good. This is definitely gonna give somebody else tingles. And it's just so funny to me that that's what happens. Like, I don't know if the other ASMRists can relate, but I definitely can fall asleep to my own videos. I think that's why sometimes it's always so crucial for me to get no sound in videos, because I really try my hardest to give out really good content, and that's why I have a Blue Yeti mic, that's why I got the green screen and the ring light. I'm probably gonna get a couple more ring lights or a stand that has one, because I want my face to not have so much shadow. But anyways, that's neither here nor there yet. I'll probably order it this Friday now. That's a plan. So, is anybody in university or college or anything right now? I am. It is going. Okay. It's crazy because this is probably always paid for school myself, or had scholarships, or found a way to pay for school. But now, I don't have enough money to attend next semester, which is fine. That's why I kind of started to do YouTube. You know, I think I can be successful without school, but it kind of sucks to know that I would have to get a loan to finish my education, and I don't want to do that. I've never had to have my parents pay for my schooling either, which I pride myself on. So, I'm not going to be going back to school next semester, and my mom doesn't know that yet, but I'll definitely break the news to her soon. As well. I definitely have boundaries when it comes to that. I don't especially from the ASMR community. But I think this is the right and perfect time for me to make this channel anyways, because there's not a lot of people who look like me, I suppose, or kind of have my vibe or my identity. I am unique and of myself. Everybody is. Of skincare are best, because there are some people who will do like a 12-step skincare routine, and I feel like their skin looks worse than when they would just do two or three items. And I don't know, I mean, no judgment to them, no shade. It is what it is. People's skins is different. And I honestly can say I was blessed in that I went through all my acne phase really early in life. It was about 6th and 7th grade. Phase, and then like after 7th grade going into 8th and 9th, my skin pretty much cleared up of every and all acne I had. Also, with my diet change being vegan, I have noticed that, you know, zits are non-existent. They're pretty much, they don't exist now, because you're constantly eating a clean diet, and a diet that is full of fiber, and a diet that is full of nutrients that help, you know, to push out the bacteria and keep the good bacteria in. The bad bacteria keep the good bacteria in. Did I say that? Hopefully I did. Well, anyways, you get the idea. It just helps to cleanse and detox your body every single day. And the thing is that your body is constantly working. Like, your heart is constantly pumping. People don't realize this, but your heart is constantly pumping. If your heart stops, then you're dead. Like, if it stops, then it's like, okay, you're in serious trouble. So it's like, and your stomach is also working as well a lot of the times. Sometimes when you don't eat and you hear that like weird noise that your stomach makes, there's a reason for that. It's not just because, you know, your stomach's there. It's because it's working. So I'm a big believer in just kind of giving your stomach a break, and I think that's why a lot of spiritual practices tell, especially Westerners, to tell them to fast, because they know a lot of people eat junk and eat animals, and not that it's bad to eat animals. Well, to me, it's bad to eat animals because of a certain crying, but it's okay. It's okay. It's okay. We got this. So I recorded them in the morning, and I forgot. So when I put this green screen up, I have to close my door because my door currently holds my green screen. That's why sometimes there's like weird wrinkles or whatever. You probably can't even really tell in the image, but I have to close my door because that is how the green screen stays up. And so once I closed it, I got it in the perfect position, right? And I was all set up, my microphone set up, my camera set up, everything is set up, and I forgot to grab water. Water, I drink so much water a day. I love water. I mean, just obsessed with at the time. So obviously when it comes to fitness, I also was researching different body types and how exercises affect people differently, and I also have done a 23andMe, so I definitely know my DNA background and what I am. Like I said, I think I've told you all, I'm like 47-48% indigenous from people. And so I don't know what tribe specifically I'm from, but my family says we're also Yaqui Indian, which is the indigenous people that moved from Mexico, Chihuahua, I believe, to Sedona, Arizona, and then had their oh my gosh, what is it called, reservation there. But I think only my great-grandmother was connected to that reservation, but she got out of it. Anyways, so I've been researching a lot on, like, my tribe and kind of, like, what body type I have, and I found out that I'm actually mesomorph, and there's three. There's the ectomorph, there's mesomorph, and endomorph. So types of people who are really tall and thin, or they're like, if they're short, they're very thin, and their shoulders pretty much, they match up with, their shoulders may be longer, like broader, and their torsos are very flat, they're smaller, their hips are smaller than it's also quick to lose it. So, like, you literally, as for my body type, mesomorph, and also, like, I feel like people, my genetic makeup, it's like you can quickly gain muscle, but you can quickly lose it. And it's like there's no, like I said, there's no off days. You have to be constantly working on yourself. And I'm just like, great. Like, I guess it's a blessing to be able to gain muscle quickly. But it's also like a curse. It's also with my teeth as well. If I miss a night of brushing my teeth, like if I, before the Rona, I used to always like go out with friends and stuff. And if I went out with them and like, you know, we smoked and we just had like a fun time, and then I went to bed and I just fell asleep, the next morning my teeth would look so yellow, and it was honestly so disgusting. I would have to do double time, and it just, now I just understand why, you know, why people say everybody is different, because it is very true. Everybody is different, and your genes are different, the way your body and the types of food that you eat, how it grounds you, or how it doesn't ground you, or whatever. You have to find exactly what it is that works for you. And I don't know. I just feel like in such a good place right now as far as my fitness is concerned. I've been working on it now and been getting a lot better. Oh my gosh, I really have been rambling this whole time. While people have been asking for me to do ramble videos, so here I am. I'm just enjoying, I'm honestly just enjoying having this ring light and my green screen. It doesn't look that cute now because I don't even know what picture I'm gonna put up. Probably something darker so you guys can sleep well and not have to worry about looking at a bright screen trying to see my face. But yeah, honestly, I'm just so happy. I feel like my ASMR game is just getting better and better and better. Yeah, at this point, I'm just talking to myself. I'm so humble, I swear. So anyways, tell me, what kind of music have you guys been listening to? Oh yeah, I don't think I finished, so I just was talking about the Charlie XCX album, but I did mention Chloe and Ale. I don't know who else. I'm waiting for Kelly Uchis to drop her new album, because she had released Kiyomando with Rico Nasty, and that song was very, very good. It's very short though. A lot of Spanish songs, or, you know, a lot of reggaeton and things like that. Like, those songs are always the shortest. They're always really good, but they're always like 2 minutes and 30 seconds, 2 minutes and 35 seconds, 2 minutes and 50 seconds. Like, I like long songs. Like, 3 minutes is like the minimum for me. I like four and up. I don't know, I just feel like long songs, like more verses, more lyrical content is really, really good. And if a pop song has a really catchy hook, I could probably listen to the hook for like the whole way through, because some pop songs really, really, really are so addictive to me and so fun to listen to. It's so interesting how the United States is kind of like the influencer of the world. And I don't mean to sound, that sounds so arrogant, and it sounds like something an American would say, but I feel like most of the artists in America have the most influence around the world. Like, I know like everybody around the world knows who Beyonce and Jay-Z is, or like Nicki Minaj or Selena Gomez. I'm trying to think of whom else. Maybe not Selena, maybe that's more here, but because it was at the Waverly Place and stuff. But I just noticed that a lot of American stars are very big around the world. Oh, Lana Del Rey. People love Lana Del Rey. It's so crazy. They go crazy after her. All the gays love her. She is low-key canceled right now, though, I think. enough name dropping celebrities. I don't want to get sued now. God forbid. I just wanted to talk to you all and see how you guys are doing. Whenever this reaches you, just want to let you know that you are special. Is gone.